Good morning, Mike.
So we'll go through some of the specifics in just a couple of moments with the letter, but first of all, the broadest of questions. Is there anything that's going to come and bite you on the bum or haunt you?
No. Categorically, absolutely no. And I guess that's one of the disappointing things about all this, because allegations are easy to make. They're often harder to defend.
So have you seen the letter, I take it?
Yes, I've seen that letter. Saw that letter a couple of weeks ago.
Right, so
whatever the date was.
They're serious allegations. You take them as serious allegations?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, look forward to knocking them off one by one. Well, a lot of them already knocked off, but, you know, knocking them off one by one, all the ones that are left.
Okay. Let me quote you some of the wording. Extremely concerned about how taxpayer money is paid by MB has been used. What does that refer to? What are their concerns?
Well, I think you've probably got to ask me more specific, because that's an overarching question, which, you know, the answer is there isn't any, there should be no concern. So I think you've got to go into the specifics to really be able to knock them down one by one.
So have you misused public money, put it that way?
No, not at all. Again, you know, let's talk specifics, because that kind of it demonstrates the case as such.
Okay. Well, what specifics do you want to talk about then?
Well, you know, for example, I mean, there's some pretty good inflammatory and sensational words in there, like fraud and Hungarian bank accounts. And I mean, your eye just goes straight to those things. So maybe let's just talk about that one first.
Okay. Is there a Hungarian bank account, and is there fraud?
Well, let me answer that, and I'll answer it totally specifically. First of all, I got to say one sort of overarching thing here is that one of the informants was in charge of the accounts of the event. And that's a really important point. So some time ago, I approved an invoice. I approve invoices all the time, of course, to a large contractor in Europe. And no, I did not check the noughts and the ones on the bank account. I approved it. It was a correct invoice. There was nothing wrong with it. It was exactly per contract. And the money was sent to Hungary. So is that fraud? Yeah, it is. It's fraud in so much that we were basically defrauded. But is it fraud in the sense that it's been portrayed in the paper this morning? Absolutely not. More importantly, instantly we rang MB, told them what had happened and that it was not government money, because it wasn't. And secondly, we got straight into the fraud police, who have been working carefully with out of New Zealand, but into Belgium and across through Interpol, and we've recovered some of that money. So when you use sensational words like that, you really got to find out what's behind them first.
Okay, so explain to me, you were simply paying an invoice to a contractor, but there was some fraud involved and you got that money back. Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm saying that there was fraud in so much that we were defrauded to an incorrect bank account. And yes, no, we haven't got all the money back. We've got a lot of the money back, or some of the money back at this stage.
How are you defrauded, and by who?
Well, we were defrauded by scammers, so we don't really know. And, you know, the police don't know yet and probably will never know. But some of the money's back. And in the end, the ultimate noughts, ones and whatever numbers on the bank account in the invoice that was paid weren't checked.
Right. So the scammers defrauded you, but that is entirely separate to what you were doing with the money and paying the contractor that happened to go to a Hungarian bank account. Does that make sense?
155% correct.
Right. So do they accept that as an explanation, though, or is that part of their overarching concern?
No, that's one of their overarching concerns. And I go back to one of the other questions or sort of has been put up this morning, that we have been in some way obstructive to MB. And the answer is, did we shut down a little bit on all of this about 6 weeks ago while we were in a COVID environment? Yes, we did, because we suspected the questioning was unusual, and we suggested that to answer a lot of the questions, we weren't prepared to put it in writing. It was simply they should look over our shoulder in the office. I'll give you an example. A number of the people within Team New Zealand work across both events, legal, logistics, on and off water, which is fairly normal, because otherwise you've got to employ all those people that wouldn't have a full-on job in one of the events. But we weren't prepared to give the salaries to, if you like, back engineer those percentages out during COVID for reasons that are now pretty obvious. And suggested that they looked over our shoulder on the screen and checked them themselves.
ACE, this is the organiser, have used part of the event investment for costs that have arisen but were not in relation to the management and delivery of the events. What do they mean by that?
Well, I just answered that question.
That's exactly what you were just explaining.
Yeah.
Okay. This includes the $3 million loan to Emirates, which has subsequently been reclassified in the payment that was made to the Hungarian bank account through fraud, and you've answered that part as well.
Well, yes and no, because there's sort of a couple more claims in there. First of all, there's been no loan, and secondly, the amount to the Hungarian defrauded bank account wasn't that figure. So there's a tie-in of three things which don't relate to each other. There's right. never been a loan to Team New Zealand from the event, never.
Right. Material relationships with third parties that are not documented, which can be terminated upon 30 days' notice. What does that mean?
Yeah, well, I'm not 100% sure what that one means, to be fair, saying there's no effectively contract with someone that can be terminated in 30 days. So I can't tie those two together. Theoretically, if you can terminate someone in 30 days, it's got to be written down somewhere. So, again, you know, that's a claim that we need to work with Envy, which we've been doing, because I don't even know what that one is, actually.
Okay. They're extremely concerned about the ability of ACE America's Cup event to deliver safe and successful events. This is where we get into what you would call health and safety. Is that right?
Yeah, and absolutely. And that's a really important one. And it's really important to us, frankly, possibly the most important thing. And so I can talk specifically to that. I got involved in this part of it, and we're talking on water here, a couple of months ago. Didn't feel right. What I found was 45 chase boats, some of which would be anchored, but a lot of which number would be moving around within the crowd, manned by well-meaning and, you know, bless them, volunteers with clipboards and fluoro jackets. Now, I actually think that's a hazard in itself. So we suggested back that it should be a significantly less volunteer chase boat number, but it should be bolstered with people with authority, police, on the water. We saw that as the better combination. And to sort of give that some credibility, the guy that is running this, the on-water operations guy, has done the last two. And those numbers of boats are even higher than what he recommended. So do we have a dispute on that? We absolutely do. I mean, this is not our first rodeo. I watched the restart of the Volvo race here a couple of years ago. It was an absolute shambles, and that was a health and safety issue.
Right.
We treat health and safety very, very importantly.
Grant, we've got to wrap this up. Is there anything else you want to say?
No, other than, you know, this is, you know, really unfortunate for the team. It's quite obvious why this was leaked by the informants.